Hello and welcome to the Study Travel TV studio in London. I'm Matthew Knott.
And I'm Nicola Hancox, bringing you the latest news stories.
So the headlines this week, big increase in Canada's language sector.
French in Normandy joins International House.
And USA confirms new student visa overstay rules.
And lots of other big stories this week as well. So, starting in Canada then?
Yes, member schools of Languages Canada welcomed a record peak of almost 150,000 international students in 2017, a 10% increase compared with the previous year, according to the four-year data released by the association recently.
With a 13% increase, Brazil became the largest source country with 23,500 students, followed by Japan, China, Korea and Mexico, with the latter recording a healthy 41% rise compared with the previous year.
The increase was the largest registered by Languages Canada for several years, but Gonzalo Peralta, Executive Director, cautioned that the growth may have been heavily influenced by external geopolitical factors and urged continued investment in promotion and refinement of policies at national and provincial level.
The average stay decreased slightly to 10.8 weeks, which Languages Canada attributed to more junior students and new short stay visa arrangements for key markets. Around 6% of students enrolled were on French language programmes.
And staying with the French language, International House World Organisation, or IHWO, has announced the affiliation of French in Normandy to its school network.
Yes, the organisation said French in Normandy would adopt the name IH Rouen and added that this was an exciting expansion of the IH brand in France. Becky Wigglesworth, operations manager at IH, said they hoped it would be a milestone moment for the association and the school.
Larry Maitland, school director, said they were looking forward to working together with IH and becoming a dynamic member of the network.
Yeah, interesting. Okay, back across the Atlantic again, where the US Citizenship and Immigration Services Department has now implemented new rules on student visa overstays, meaning that international students on F, M or J visas now start accruing unlawful presence the day after they are no longer studying.
Individuals that accrue more than 180 days of unlawful presence may be barred from further admission to the USA. A slight concession compared with the previously announced draft policy is that students will not accrue unlawful presence while an application for reinstatement is pending.
And now for a roundup of some of the other news stories this week. Promotional body Study Perth has announced that connecting study and work and raising awareness of the city as a destination will be its priorities in coming years, following the release of a survey of over 5,000 prospective and current international students and more than 300 agencies.
Good. The New Zealand government has released its international education strategy with a new focus on high-value international students and a target of growing the value of the sector to $6 billion New Zealand dollars. The strategy is formed around three pillars: student experience, sustainable growth, and global citizens.
The British Council has launched a new four-week free online MOOC course to help prepare incoming international university students for study and life in the UK, starting from early September.
New Horizons Australia Institute of Technology has announced a pathway partnership with Kaplan International English and a credit transfer agreement with Southern Cross University.
The UK's De Montfort University has unveiled a new pathway partnership with Asia Pacific University of Technology and Innovation in Malaysia.
And the USA has educated more world leaders than any other destination, edging ahead of the UK this year, according to annual analysis by the UK-based Higher Education Policy Institute. The Prime Ministers of Japan, Australia and Pakistan are among the high-profile former international students listed in the report.
Wow. More on all of those stories on our website, as well as a few photos to get you in the mood for the Star Awards,
yes,
where we have a reminder of our illustrious superstars, including, of course, French in Normandy.
Absolutely. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.
Goodbye.